The Gen 2 Haldex system, equipped on all-wheel drive S40s and V50s, is a reactive system, meaning when it detects slip at the front wheels, it supplies power to the rear wheels with a 70-30 power split from front to rear. This is great for handling and for driving in snow, but it's not an all-wheel drive system that can compete on a level with the STI, Evo, or the Focus RS. However, Moosetech discovered that swapping a Gen 3 Haldex controller from the V8 XC90, an option Volvo calls instant traction, will completely transform how the car drives. The upgraded Haldex controller is only available in the first generation XC90 V8s and some 3.2-liter XC90s. The exact part number for Haldex is 5WP33504-01, and Volvo's part number is 36001160. Do not be misled by many of the other controller part numbers which came equipped on the 3.2-liter XC90. It is also vital that you have both the solenoid and the oil pressure sensor which come off of the donor vehicle. Once you have the differential electronic module ready, remove the sensor and the solenoid to transfer to your car. Two small Allen screws hold the controller in place. Disconnect the two electrical wiring clips, then remove the controller. To minimize the amount of fluid from leaking out, I'm swapping the sensor immediately. I'm sorry for the bad camera angle as I was working fast. Be certain the orientation of the electrical connector lines up with the Haldex controller. Also be sure the small washer is lined up correctly as well. Then simply install the new controller, connect the wiring clips, and replace the two screws. The upgraded Haldex controller primes a pump upon key start, so the rear wheels are ready to go almost immediately. The result is a car that drives like a true all-wheel drive vehicle. While there's no easy at-home way of determining the new power split, it is believed that it is a 60-40 front-to-rear split, which seems logical based on how the car drives and how much quicker the rear wheels spin with the new controller installed. Putting your foot down through a turn can very easily result in the back end kicking out into a drift before the front wheels pull you out of it. Accelerating in a straight line truly pushes and pulls you along. Just because the back end can kick out so effortlessly does not make this a drift mode like the new RS. Considering the three-piece drive shaft and the tiny rear axles, I would highly discourage attempting to build a drift mode for this car with stock parts. While this swap is successfully working, with no warning lights and no errors, on a 2009 with DSTC and on my 2006 with no traction control, we cannot yet confirm that this will flawlessly work on all P1 Volvos. The real testing begins now, as we determine how this modification affects the fuel economy and how the rear differential holds up with the added power. As a full disclaimer, the handling characteristics of the car will be transformed from an easy-driving all-wheel-drive Volvo to a rather insane all-wheel-drive system. While the car is a lot more fun to drive and actually feels like a real sports car, you will have to completely relearn how to drive the car. Throttle control is key, as simply mashing the gas pedal can easily make the back wheels spin.